Anyway, morning everyone. Thank you, Paul, for the intro, and thanks everyone for letting me have a few minutes just to speak about what we're doing at ODIHQ. I'll share my screen because I've got a few slides that will help walk us through it. You should be able to see that now. Paul, do you want to give me a thumbs up? Or somebody at Leeds to give me a thumbs up? Yeah, great, thanks. With our project, we got a little bit of funding through Luminate, so I want to talk through what we've been doing with that and how we've been trying to help people. But what I'm going to talk about here is mostly on the link that's on this slide, so the odi.org/topic/COVID-19, where everything is. I was just going to go through a few of the guides that we've been producing. So when we started the project, the idea of helping out, very similar to ODI Leeds, you know, helping people get access to data to help with decision making during the crisis, and a part of the funding we have scope to help people and support organizations to make models, data models and software, as open as possible. So those were our three main focuses. We put out a call for interest, you know, people who wanted help, and we had over 100 submissions in the first week to that call. We boiled them down into three main things that people were looking for help with around our expertise. One, publishing guidance and tools. Okay, common theme there. Let's get some data out there. Anonymization, obviously a lot of the data being about people. And the third one being ethics. So what we've done initially with the project is focused around how we can help organizations and people with those three things. So the first one that we started on was to boil down a simple guide to publishing open data in times of crisis. So that's got three key steps in it that Paul and the team, I'm sure, have talked about lots. And to back up that guide, we also did a little bit of work on our Octopub tool. Don't know if people have come across Octopub before. It's a GitHub-based data publishing tool. It's like a front end on GitHub that's purely written for data. Upload data, put a license on it, press go, and it generates you a nice, as you can see here in the bottom right-hand corner, a GH Pages kind of web page with the data in it. We've been extremely interested to see who is having it. In fact, people might have seen that the TUC have started publishing all the COVID Secure Check assessments. We're encouraging people to publish the COVID Secure Check assessments using Octopub. Okay, so if people are interested in that, you can look up COVID Secure Check and find out how many organizations currently publish assessments, and then they're all published via, they're saying that use Octopub, it's a nice, easy to use tool. So that one, actually we found out about, I think on Twitter, so that was amazing that someone had come across it and using a tool was nice when that happened. So we did a little bit of maintenance to Octopub to make sure that it's, you know, reliable, so that again we haven't used for a few years, but these kind of simple tools during a crisis. So if you're interested, Octopub.io for that one. So the guide alongside a tool. Another project work with that came through this process was track together, which is one of the symptom trackers. This is again something that's been very hot during COVID. A lot of these are about, and the NHSX have started saying about getting a lot of data together from them. I'll talk about that in a minute. But Track Together contacted us as they wanted some help just to, with things like anonymizing and publishing the data openly. So again, we kind of pointed them to the guide through. They didn't quite use Octopub for it, but they did pull the data from GitHub. And we also helped them do some bits around anonymizing the data. So on the back of that, we also produced a seven-step little guide for people, practical guide on anonymizing data. This one's quite interesting because what we did with it, we did it practically to give people an example that's relevant to COVID-19. So we backwards engineered the NHS 111999 data to put personal data back in it. So we made up some, you know, people from Harry Potter, wizard names, etc., you know, if you like that kind of thing, and put that kind of personal data back in 111999 data, and then demonstrated how, right, you go about anonymizing that to produce the data set that they are publishing. So that's how we kind of made that relevant to the current situation. So if people are interested in that, it includes a practical walkthrough that goes through these seven steps for a hypothetical, but close to the actual data set. So there's a guide there and with the practical example in. In terms of ethics, a lot of discussion, and there has been a lot of discussion around these three things and the confusion between them. There's a lot of data about people being collected right now in various different ways, and these different types of services that people are talking about, the symptom tracker, contact tracer, immunity passport. I'm sure you've all come across these different ones. So one of the first things that we started was to write an explainer for these, and we produced some, our team produced some great graphics that people can use to help people tell the difference between these. And then alongside that, we wrote an explainer that also points towards some of the ethical issues with each of these and the differences between them. Because what we've been looking at is what happens long term. A lot of people have been starting to consider that. What happens afterwards? You know, where does this data go? Where's the benefits that come in the long term? Okay, and how would we do that in a way that is ethical? So, you know, our general line, you know, technology can be helpful, but it's important that it's effective, well-built and proportionate. And we've seen a lot of emphasis on that over the last couple of weeks with things like the diversity, inclusion, Black Lives Matter, all the rest of this around. It's got to be, you know, relevant and proportional for everyone. And it's important to do those kind of innovations in the open. So this is where we've been looking at how the ethics canvas can help. And we hope next week to have another guide up that boils down our data ethics canvas to help people get a grip with what you might need to think about, you know, in times of crisis, how to think about ethics. So hopefully that guide will be up next week. Going forward, we've got a couple of key focuses. Focus one, we're working a lot in the area of best practices for data made available by symptom trackers. There's a lot of talk out there about whether there's a need for standardization, whether there's a need to set, you know, to bring data to convenient around, you know, some kind of standard, some kind of reusable way. Whereas a lot of others are saying, well, just gather all the data together. So we're kind of having a voice in this area. And I mentioned about the latest news where NHS Digital are partnering up with J-Hub. So this is an interesting development that we didn't necessarily know all about. So we're going to be keeping an eye on that one and hoping to feed into that conversation. Focus two that we're going to be looking at is around mobility as we get back to normal. There's been some interesting work by one of the ODI supporters, Geolytics, in this area already, looking at what's now happening as a result of in the UK they've been looking at, but in different countries around as lockdown is lifted, how do we start to use this opportunity to help us understand how to get mobile again, or the restrictions that might need to be in place depending on how we need to potentially live with COVID-19 in the long term. So what kind of services might we need to know about for when things are quieter, when transport is quieter, when it's best to go on certain things. So mobility might be a hugely changing sector. So we're looking at that in terms of there's a lot of data currently being made available, but a lot of it's got conditions like only during COVID. You know, what happens if we live with COVID? Okay, what happens in that situation? How do we mobilize the data to help us to deal with living with it? So this is our focus too, and we're doing a lot of research on that at the moment, and there's a lot of week notes as well on the website. So that was I'm trying to keep Paul on time, so hopefully that was a rapid tour through three of the things that we've been doing. Helping people publish being the first one. We've been doing a lot in the anonymization space, you know, and a lot in the ethics space with those two focuses around symptom tracking and mobility. So if you want to know more, all of this is available on our topic page on the website. So that's the only thing. All the guides, everything is linked there. And again, guide should go with tool. So hopefully they match together. And that's a little update from ODIHQ.